As I'm sure you know, most carriers, at least in the US, will throttle services such as YouTube or Netflix, effectively cutting down the video quality of the service that you're streaming from. For example, with YouTube and T-Mobile, they'll throttle your service to about 480p quality video, unless you pay an extra $10 or $15 a month for that higher quality, either 1080p or 4K. The way that they do this is they basically identify your traffic as either YouTube or Netflix or any other streaming service, and then they'll just throttle just that connection. So you'll do a speed test and you'll get, you know, hundreds and hundreds of megabits per second for the download, but then you open up YouTube and you're limited to 480p. Now, the best way to get around this is to basically mask your traffic and not let them identify what you're doing. So the best way to do this is, of course, through a VPN. And there are ways to pay for VPNs, which will get you access to, you know, choosing which country you want a VPN from, things like that. But if you're just looking for just a way to unlock that streaming bandwidth for a service such as YouTube, then you can use a service called 1.1.1.1, which is provided by Cloudflare. Now, if you're not familiar with Cloudflare, they basically run a lot of the internet. They host a lot of servers and as well as DNS servers. So whenever you type in a URL, such as youtube.com, it'll use that DNS server to effectively look up youtube.com and kind of translate it into an IP address, for example. So in order to get around the throttling for certain video streaming services, we can go into the App Store and we'll just search for 1.1.1.1. And we'll get the app provided by Cloudflare. So it's 1.1.1.1, faster internet, and we'll just download that. We can open it up, press next, accept to the terms, and we'll install a VPN profile. You can choose whether or not to allow notifications. I don't really think it's necessary. Now here we are. This is basically the main on and off switch for our VPN, but we want to change some settings. So if we go to the top right corner, we want to make sure that we're on warp. 1.1.1.1 will only do DNS lookups through the Cloudflare servers, but warp will do the DNS lookup as well as just tunneling all of your VPN traffic through the Cloudflare servers. So we want to check that and then just press done. Now there's one other setting that I forgot to mention. So if we go back into here and we go to advanced and we go to connection options, we can choose to add a Wi-Fi network. So basically we can have this only enable when we're on cellular. So if you're at home and you're streaming YouTube at full quality anyway, you don't really need to tunnel all your VPN traffic through Cloudflare. You can just have it go through its normal protocol and you'll be just fine. So we're gonna add a Wi-Fi network. This is gonna be my home network that I wanna add. So we'll just type in the name of it. So I added my Wi-Fi network. Just make sure you type it in exactly the way that it is in the Wi-Fi settings. Just make sure that it knows exactly which Wi-Fi network is yours and so it doesn't enable during that. If we want, we can just have it disabled through all Wi-Fi networks. So if you're constantly switching between your home network, your work, your office network, things like that, we can just have it disabled for all Wi-Fi and only have it enable for cellular service. And with it set up this way, it's going to be automatically enabling when you're connected to cellular. So it's going to disconnect and you're going to get the full speed on any Wi-Fi network. But once you switch over to cellular only, it'll enable. Once we back out to the main menu, it should say that it's disconnected and then it's disabled on trusted Wi-Fi networks, and then it'll list the network that you're currently connected to, assuming that's your own Wi-Fi network that you inputted into the settings. So to test that it automatically enables, we'll go ahead and turn off Wi-Fi. And then we should see the VPN logo in the top left corner, and it is connected. Now if we go back to the app, it should say that it's checking connectivity and that it is connected. Now, if you were to go to YouTube or some other platform, it should stream the full quality, assuming that your actual cellular connection is good. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you want to bypass your carrier's restrictions on streaming quality and you want to, you know, take advantage of their actual network speeds, this is the best way to do it. Just run everything through a VPN so they can't identify your traffic and they can't throttle certain services. Anyway, that's it for this educational video. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.